This is my Slinky machine, or Slinky escalator, and I've already made a video showing off this machine, and in this video I'll talk more about the backstory and problems with the machine. The idea for this machine was actually my friend Eric's years and years ago, and I've teased him about it from time to time ever since, but I've eventually concluded he's never going to build it himself, so I figured it was fair game for me to build it. The idea was actually for the machine to be motorized and have some kind of system for detecting where the slinky is to adjust the speed so that the whole machine could run autonomously. But the machine is actually far too unreliable for that, so automating it would make no sense whatsoever. Eric's idea had been to have some contacts on the steps and some kind of commutation back to the fixed part of it to detect where the slinky is, but given how hard it is to keep the slinky on track, I don't think this would work very well because it wouldn't make reliable contact. I'd been thinking about just having some light beep shoot across so that the slinky interrupts it. But realistically, if I were to add control to it, I'd probably just use my Raspberry Pi and process the images, just because I've already got experience doing that. So just to keep things simple, I figured a hand crank is the best solution. There are two main problems with achieving reliable slinkification, and those are stride and tracking. Tracking being that the slinky doesn't go off to the side like this. And the way I've solved that problem is just to tilt the whole machine this way a little bit. I could also just tilt the individual steps and then have something on here that's fairly flat and smooth. So if the slinky does rub against here, it doesn't affect it too much and it'll still continue to go down the steps. I had been experimenting with putting a piece of veneer on here to help keep the slinky on track, because if the step is sloped a little bit, it will send it in that direction. But I found even just with a 1 millimeter thick piece of veneer, if it hit that, it deflected it to the side by so much that it would really slam it into the sideboard, and that would actually throw it off track. Ideally, the steps would be a lot wider and have a very shallow dip to them, and I think that would be successful at keeping the slinky going down the steps roughly in the middle. Another solution would be just to put a piece of plexiglass in front, but I don't like the thing that's moving to be behind the piece of plexiglass, because I like it so I can just reach in there and grab the slinky. More challenging has been stride control on this thing, which is to make sure that the slinky doesn't overshoot the next step and then just starts tumbling down, or maybe it might undershoot and then not make it over the next step. I can slightly alter the stride of the slinky by either changing the slope of the steps or just by tilting the whole machine, so the shots I've just shown were actually with this push stick underneath here, and that was enough for the slinky to overshoot the steps. If the steps are angled back a little bit, the slinky's slide decreases, and if they're angled forward, it increases. And so to help keep the stride roughly centered, I sanded a very shallow hollow into each step, which you can barely see here. So that way, when the slinky's riding on the front of the steps, it sends it back a bit, and if it's on the back of the steps, it sends it forward a little bit. It also helps that if the slinky is too far back, they can drag over the nose of the steps without getting too messed up. So I rounded all the fronts of the steps, and ideally I put some slippery varnish on there to make that work even better. When the slinky is descending a set of regular stairs, it really relies on dragging over the nose to get that stride right. I made my steps 10 centimeters tall and 10 centimeters horizontal per step. And for my slinky that's almost 6 centimeters long and almost 7 centimeters in diameter, that works just barely. But realistically, I should have chosen a step size a bit longer, maybe 11 centimeters tall and 11 centimeters this way, and that way I could just rely on dragging over the nose to get that stride right. But this machine is already pretty big as it is, so I wasn't about to rebuild it with even bigger steps. The whole machine is actually very much an experiment, but there just isn't enough point in optimizing and perfecting a machine that is fundamentally useless. A mistake I actually made is I drilled the holes in here too big so that the nails don't stick in here, which has the problem that these nails sometimes tend to drift out, especially if I take the chain off. But this turns out to be much less of a problem, because on this side the backer board keeps pushing them in, and to keep the chain on track I had to add this bearing here, and I just placed it so that as the nails move past this bearing it just pushes them back in so that the nails don't come out. And why did I build this machine? Well, just to make interesting content. Because if I build a dresser, that's really useful, but it doesn't get a whole lot of views. But one thing I've learned is useless crap on YouTube gets a lot of views.